So Photoshop Beta just got a big update, and in fact, it just got another update yesterday, so make sure you download the latest version. And we're going to be looking at Firefly Model 3, but specifically inside of a new feature called Generative Image. Generative Image is essentially bringing Firefly into Photoshop with a lot of different options that we can stylistically and other ways with reference images. We can do a lot of things with our images. Let's check it out. Firefly Model 3 is now inside of Photoshop Beta. Now, there's another new feature too, and that's the Generate Image. So you have to start with a document, otherwise this is not going to appear. But then you can either choose Generate Image from the bar here, or you can go down to the bottom of the toolbox and hit it, and you're going to get this window. And we're going to explore this today. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a prompt in. And we're going to do bewildered happy cat curled up in front of lots of vintage. Well, you can read it. And we're going to just choose photo. We're going to look at all these other options in a second. But right now, we're just going to do that. And we're going to choose generate. And right now, this is going to generate just like generative fill. However, generate image does a better job than generate fill at the moment. Here we go. Here's a few options there. So we've got three different options. Let me show you. So if I make a selection right now, and then I choose generate fill, you obviously have to do a selection so I can put a prompt in. I'm going to put exactly the same prompt in and choose generate. And we'll see, we've got three options here. And if you look at the eyes, it's just kind of like a little bit weird. The wires are not quite there. So this is using generative fill. And these are the generate image. As you can see, it's just better quality right now. So another big difference between generate fill and generate image. When I'm on generate image, if you look, I have the ability to use a reference image, which we covered more last week, but also I can access these different styles. So if I want to change it to something like art, I could do that and then hit generate. And now we get something completely different. Now, if I look at the layer where I did generate fill, notice I have the ability to add a reference image, but I do not have the ability to use any of these styles. All right, so let's go back and look at some of the possibilities. So if you click this button here, we get the content type where we can do effects. You'll see all these different types of effects and things are available, as well as the ability to add a reference image. But we also have a gallery here with some images that we can access as well. Now, let me just show you something. If I'm to generate a new image, and I'll put the same prompt in, we have the same options here. If we choose effects, here they are. And if we choose a reference image, we have the ability to use the reference images. In fact, why don't we start with this one here? We'll make it a photo, and we're going to generate. And notice it picks up the style of that particular image. Now, we can access these options either from the Properties panel, or we can access it here on the taskbar. Now, these options are exactly the same options as we had when we generated. Now, notice it's using the reference image. In fact, if we click, we can see there's that reference image there. And we can go through this gallery. We could choose different ones. But let me replace this image right now. What happens if we mix a bird and a cat? Let's find out. So you can see the style or the structure stayed with the cat. So the text is overriding it, but it's taking that style from there. Now, if I was to look at a different cat, we're going to get a different result. Let's grab this cat here and generate. And if you look, now we have a very similar cat, if not the same cat. Now notice the cat in the reference was standing, but this one is sitting. But if we look at the prompt, it says bewildered happy cat curled up on a wooden desk. So if I take away the curled up, so notice the words in the prompt are overriding the reference image. So let's hit generate now. Notice now it starts to take more of the pose from the reference image. It still has that bewildered look. Let's just say cat, and we'll take away bewildered happy on here and just do cat, hit generate. And now look at this. It's starting to take on the expression now, or at least this one. is starting to take on the expression from the reference image. Interesting. Okay, there's so much more we can do with this though. So watch this. If we go back to the styles, and this time we're going to choose art, let's choose techniques, and we're going to choose a painting style, and we're going to generate. And notice now, it starts to look like a painting, but still using that prompt. Okay, it can get crazier. Watch this. When we hit this reference image, this time we're going to use something completely random. This time we're going to use one of my pencil sketches. Click open. And we're going to let it generate. All right, it's taking that effect, but why is this colored? That's because we've still got the styles in here. So if we go to the acrylic paint and we just choose clear all, close it out, and then generate again, now it should take its style completely from that drawing. And look at that. Let's change this reference image to something else, replace image. So let's grab another one of my sketches where we're doing a combination of pencil and ink. And then click open and let's generate. And look at this. Now we kind of have that mix. Okay, so why don't we get rid of the reference? And we're going to choose the style. And this time let's go with a movement. Let's go for a steampunk. And we're going to choose photo. And now we're going to generate. So it's using the text prompt with no reference image. And it's got the steampunk style. And here we go. Now, obviously, the biggest difference is if you look at the gauges and stuff behind it, it's more of a kind of a steampunky, like some of these ones particular. But let's click in here and let's go for an art style. And look at this. We got some interesting ones here. Let's change the style, the movement. Instead of steampunk, let's do a cyberpunk. And see, that's kind of cool. But let's go for a realistic style. So we're going to go from art to photo. And why don't we give it hyperrealism? And let's generate. I really like that one. Let's see what else we can do with the effects, though. Let's give it a fisheye effect. And look at that, how fun. Let's go back to this one. We're going to clear these out. And let's give it a comic book look. And we're going to go for art. And generate. And here we have a comic book effect. And by the way, there's a new update to the beta just happened yesterday. So make sure you update it to the newest version. Because this is certainly working a lot better than it did 2 days ago. So as you can see, this is really fun and you could just keep experimenting all day long. I'm curious, let me know in the comments underneath what you think of this feature. Now, obviously, no, generate image is not a feature specifically for photographers. But having said that, you could use it for creating mood boards. You could use it for creating lighting references and inspiration, you know, for setting up your shoot. So it definitely has that practical use, but it definitely is more for the graphic designer and digital artist. And if you're new here to the cafe, welcome. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And if you want to see all the new generative AI features inside of Photoshop Beta, check out this video right here. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.